Howdy, boys and girls, and thank you for joining us on our ride to Balmorhea. On the way there, George and I couldn't help but doing a little bit of clowning around.
Leaving the campgrounds, we passed by some beautiful old historic buildings in Fort Davis, including the fort itself, which we wound up going to the next morning, and toured the facilities, which have been largely rebuilt.
We're about to pass one of my favorite trees. Every time we go under it, it feels like we're going through a tunnel.
This particular stretch of Highway 17 is not that long, but the combination of curves and stunning scenery with volcanic rock looming over our heads along the edges makes for a particularly enjoyable ride, in my opinion, and this just happens to be one of my favorite stretches of road out in this area.
Here you can see some 35 million year old volcanic rock, but I like to call it the asparagus rocks. That's what it looked like to me, is a bunch of asparagus. Here we pulled off and visited a rest area, and George gave me a couple quick lessons on how to run the drone. I think this was my first time to really give it a test drive. And I think for the most part, I did a pretty good job for my first time.
Just for the record, I thought Robin did a fantastic job of running the drone and getting these beautiful shots of the local landscape with these dramatic outcroppings of volcanic rock sticking up amongst this beautiful road.
George was so impressed that I didn't crash the drone on my first time. He did a celebratory happy dance, and I jumped for joy because I didn't break the thing.
Shortly after leaving the rest stop here, you will break free from the tighter curves and jagged outcroppings of rock, and you will find yourself on the flat open plain of West Texas at the foothill of the Davis Mountain Range.
The ground was dry, but the air was full of sound. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name.
Whoa, now that we've officially found the horse with no name, I think we need to move on to another song, don't you guys?
Sitting at the base of the Davis Mountain Range is this amazing oasis, which is sitting on the edge of the desert. Welcome to our very brief tour of Balmorhea State Park. This particular park is known for its very large natural spring-fed swimming pool, and it was at one time and may still be considered the largest natural spring-fed swimming pool in the world. As you enter into the park, off to the left you will see these beautiful little cabins, which are surrounded by a natural spring-fed canal. And you can't really see it in this video shot, but that canal is actually just off to the left underneath these massive old trees. which provide beautiful shade for just hanging out during the summer months. As we roll into the back area, you will see that this park has provisions for power and water for RVs, as we make our way around to the very back side, there is some more primitive parking available for tent camping, and yet still also have a little bit of shade provided by these little structures that you can see that match a little bit of a white adobe. If you are planning a trip to this park, be very well aware that in the summer months, this park gets packed. So packed that they have to limit the amount of people coming in for day use for the swimming pool. And subsequently, that makes for getting any vacancies in either the cabins or camping areas very limited. So you want to try and get your reservations in pretty good advance, or you will not be staying here.
Even though it was fun touring the park, I was a little disappointed that we couldn't go swimming. But neither one of us had brought our bathing suits, and it was pretty late in the day. There was nobody there to let us use the park. So we figured we'd just stop by in another time. So our next video is going to be touring the actual fort in Fort Davis. So tune in next time, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.